My name is Muriel Engleman, and my age is 90 and 9/10. I served as an Army nurse during World War II for 3 years. My first deployment was at Fort Adams, Rhode Island. I wanted overseas duty, so I applied for a unit that was activating for overseas duty. The Battle of the Bulge took place. It was a 6-week battle that lasted from December 16, 1944 to January 28, 1945. And it was the biggest, the bloodiest, and the most decisive battle of World War II. Our hospital was 54 miles away from Bastogne, where it was centered at that point. Hitler started sending buzz bombs into Liège, Belgium, where our hospital was located. These buzz bombs each carried 2,000 pounds of explosives, and they came over every 10 to 15 minutes, 24 hours a day, and they came for the next 2.5 months. The bodies of our troops were so mutilated, they cut off their fingers and hands, not just to get their rings and watches, but to get their warm winter gloves, which the German army did not have. And this was the coldest winter with the most snow that the Belgians had seen in almost 100 years, with temperatures frequently going down to 37 degrees below zero. The Germans desecrated those bodies, they gouged out eyes and just mutilated them. I have no resentment against the Germans, even though I had a dog tag that had an H on it for Hebrew, one of those who Hitler wanted to destroy. But I later had 600 German prisoners of war as patients, and they are human beings who we are accustomed to handling as human beings, not just the enemy. We treated them as we did our American soldiers. We didn't have the love for them that we did for our soldiers, but they were human beings, and we treated them accordingly.